Hey there, how are you doing? This is Kali from Techfanciers. In this video, we take an in-depth look at official evaluation X6.4 Omega Android 12 on this Redmi Note 11. I have been using this for past few days and here are my thoughts. First, build details. First, we'll start with the build details. This is the latest official evaluation X6.4 Omega with the 5th May 2022 security update compiled by Dai Hong. The kernel version is 4.19.157 and the build date is 2nd of June, running on top of the latest Android 12.1. So again, boot animation. The boot animation is the moving lightning logo of minimal evaluation XE logo. So nothing to complain here, it is fast and fine. Third, features. In terms of feature, we have a dedicated menu in settings called Evolver, where you can find all the required customization, which is great and major advantages of this room. You have an option to toggle 90Hz refresh rate, caffeine mode, lot of display related customization icons and features that we can't find in MIUI. There are some usable features where you can which you can find in the miscellaneous. You have an option to spoof like it is a Pixel device to avail the unlimited Google Photo storage. You can unlock the higher FPS in the games. You can stream content in high quality. I like all these features. One feature that I would like to mention, which is double hit something on the back of the phone. I have set it to open an app which is Triple Info, which worked flawlessly. When I intentionally double tap in the backside, it opened the app. Which is great. I believe this is one of the Pixel phone feature which is working really good. It is like having a extra button, but sometimes it just opens the app when I don't even select it, which is weird, but overall I like it so much. And the customization and feature wise, it covers all the things. Camera to API is enabled by default, so you can install Gcam. No root is required. A2 has a dedicated gaming mode with an FPS counter. Fingerprint works fine, it has a face unlock, the dual speaker works, nothing to complain about. Fourth, battery backup. Battery backup wise, it is good. I don't say it is better than MIUI or something, but I am normally getting 2 days of usage on a single charge. As it is an Android phone, we can't exactly check the screen on time from 100. As per the status from the third party battery app, the screen on time for 100 to 0 is like 9 hours to 10 hours. But remember, I am not gaming and all, just video, audio and browsing with Wi-Fi plus 4G always on. I am actually happy with this part of things. It is great and energy efficient. When it comes to charging, 0 to 100, it took like 1.5 hours to charge, which is fine. In terms of deep sleep or battery loss in the screen of time, it is like 0.5 to 0.8% per hour. So roughly every night you will lose like 5 to 10% of battery juice. Hope that answers all your questions about the charging and battery backup. Fifth thing, security and safety net. This build comes with encrypted storage, so installing and switching from this is a little bit hectic. You need to take a backup of all your internal storage. This is important. Also, if you are using a 6x6 pattern, just change it to PIN or password before formatting, so that next time you install any OS in the FRP, you can easily unencrypt it from Google back and restore it. It is secure and safety net passes. You can use banking and payment apps. Mostly in it's all I can say about the good thing. Now we see some moderate and demerits of installing this. Performance and benchmarks. Performance wise, it is normal or same as MIUI, but the thing which is making good is that we have some miscellaneous option to enable higher FPS in games. So I enabled it and opened BGMI with gaming mode enabled in high performance. In low settings, we have an option to enable 90 FPS. Trust me, it is so good. The in-game, the FPS stayed between 40 to 90, which gave me great gaming experience. I played like a half an hour and I also first time played with gyro enabled. It was so good. So gaming wise, I actually like it a lot, especially that 90Hz option. The animation and flow is buttery smooth, which I like the most. Yes, there are some glitches here and there when opening recent apps menu or quick step, but that is normal. I ran the Geekbench and this is the score. This is same as the previous Pixel Experience Plus GSI, not much different. No issues in terms of performance. Camera and video recording. There aren't many changes in terms of the camera. You have basic AOSP camera. You don't get any MIUI camera in build, or if you install also it won't work. I have installed Gcam, which works somehow fine. You can install an open camera which is stable and you can use it for day-to-day use. Now we talk about problems that this ROM has. To be honest, there aren't much issue which makes it non-stable. The ROM is fully stable in most of the cases. In terms of display, it's good. You get an option to enable high quality content. Performance, good. You will get the option to boost it. Battery, good, no complaint. So where it lags? Well, I didn't found any issue, but when going through some users note, the Zoom app isn't working properly. So I installed and tried. Yes, it is not properly working. I am unable to connect to any meeting or I'm even unable to create any meeting. Not sure if it is related to ROM or a issue from the Zoom app. I basically don't use Zoom at all. So I tried the MS Teams and the Google Meet, which is working fine. I felt like having a low audio issue in WhatsApp calls, both in loudspeaker and earpiece, but I think it is about the opposite person who is talking to me. So not a ROM issue. Other than those above things, the one thing which I have to mention is, it is not a serious issue, but I wanted to inform that the OTA update is not working. It is giving install error. I think it is due to the recent release has some modification and includes the firmware to fill in. That's great, and that's all about this review. So the conclusion is, first, it is stable, you can use it as a daily driver. Second, it is encrypted. I personally prefer encryption as I can use some corporate security apps and banking apps. Third, it has all required features and more importantly useful features. Bluetooth headphone, wired headphone, and audio related issue, there isn't anything, all working fine. Speaking about the problems, yes, if you are a student and use Zoom app to attend your classes and other things, better stick with your current ROM as it doesn't work properly. That's all about this video. I hope I have answered the queries that you may want to know before installing it. If you have any queries, please let me know in the comment section. Also, if you face any other issue then I mentioned in the video, please write it down in the comment section so others can read it before trying it out. Right after this video, I will be moving out to some other OS, so we will find better ones soon. Thanks for watching. Code Moto.